In general, in polling research and in social science research, there are some pollsters who will tell you, for example, that if you want to understand people's political leanings broadly, are they conservative or right-wing versus liberals slash left-wing, one of the simple questions to ask is their belief about evolution. So people who believe in evolution tend to be more center or center-left. People who believe in a very biblical understanding of creation tend to be more right of center in their political beliefs. For gay rights, that question is not about evolution, but it's whether you believe people are, quote, born gay, lesbian, or bisexual, or is it a chosen behavior? And people who believe that it's chosen are much more likely to not be supportive of LGBT rights compared to those who believe that you're, quote, born gay, lesbian, or bisexual. Now, the problem with those distinctions is that there's a kind of false dichotomy there. The question is probably better asked, are you born with a sexual orientation, heterosexual or gay, lesbian, or bisexual? And of course, we never ask that. We tend to focus on the GLB question. Most evidence suggests that the formation of sexual orientation is a complicated process that may involve genetics, meaning things about that you're quote born with, combined with your environment that you grew up with, other choices you make in life. That said, most people who have a same-sex sexual orientation, whether they identify as gay, lesbian, or bisexual or not, say that this is not something that they're, quote, choosing in the sense that they see it as equally probable, you know, the equal probability that they have a desire for same-sex versus different-sex partners. They see their desires as just something they have and that they didn't, quote, choose. So most gay people don't believe that they've chosen to be gay or lesbian. A complication is, though, that you do choose to call yourself gay or lesbian. You might not choose whatever sexual orientation is, but you choose what to call it. So again, it's a very nuanced, kind of in the way that it's complicated to talk about identity and your sexual behavior and the sexual attraction. It's a little complicated to talk about, well, is it something you're born with? Is it something you chose? Those are very discrete categories that don't really capture the process of the formation of all people's sexual orientation. And the truth is, we don't have definitive answers yet in that process. We certainly have some evidence, but we don't have a definitive answer. And as I said, the problem is, though, that very simple belief, whether you believe you're born with it or whether you choose it, is highly predictive of whether you support the rights of LGBT people or you believe that it's sinful or something bad, and so you're generally not supportive.